In today's video, I am going to explain anatomy of muscles that attach to particular part of pelvis. I will focus on three places today. First place is here. This is iliac crest. Iliac crest and pubis. Pubis. Then third place is ischium, particularly ischial tuberosity. There are so many muscles attaching around these places. There are many muscles around iliac crest, pubis, and ischial tuberosity. If you know these anatomy, your clinical experience, your hands-on technique can be much more efficient because there are many muscles around bony structure. So you focus on this area. Then many muscle tissues, many myofascias are affected. That is why I focus on these three places in my clinical practice. Let's get started from iliac crest. Again, this is iliac crest. I basically separate iliac crest for two parts, inferior part and superior part. It's slightly different because on inferior part of iliac crest, there are hip muscles, okay? Hip muscles. On superior part, there are core muscles. Core muscles. So if you change the intention for iliac crest, you can approach for hip muscles or core muscles. What kind of muscles are there below iliac crest? Let's see. It's like gluteus medius. Gluteus medius here. And gluteus maximus here. Gluteus maximus. How about gluteus minimus? Well, gluteus minimus is a little bit far away from iliac crest. It originates like middle part of ilium. So I don't focus to gluteus minimus around iliac crest. Gluteus medius is closer. Let's go to slightly anterior part, like this. There is tensor fascia lata. Tensor fascia lata, that's of course hip muscle. How about superior part? What kind of muscles are there? There are core muscles, like external oblique. External oblique. Internal oblique. Transverse abdominis. And let's say quadratus lumborum. There are other muscles, however, basically above iliac crest, there are core muscles. So if you know any kind of hands-on work, myofascial release, trigger point, acupuncture, other kind of hands-on technique, you can focus around iliac crest. Then your hands-on technique can affect for many muscles. This is one of my favorite places to do myofascial release. Let's go to pubis. Okay, this is anterior view. This is pubis. There are two kinds of muscles around pubis. The first one is, of course, core muscle, particularly rectus abdominis. Rectus abdominis attaches around superior part of pubis. How about inferior part of pubis? It's around this area. Well, adductor muscles attaching around this area. This is inferior ramus. Okay, inferior ramus. inferior ramus. There are adductor muscles around inferior ramus, such as adductor magnus. Adductor magnus, adductor longus, adductor brevis, pectineus, adductor minimus. Adductor muscles are attaching around inferior ramus. Again, on superior part of pubis, rectus abdominis. Around inferior ramus, adductor muscles. So, same like iliac crest. If you want to affect for rectus abdominis, you do hands-on work here. If you want to focus on adductor muscles, you focus on inferior ramus. Okay, then I want to talk about one more thing about pubis. Okay, this is posterior view. This is inferior ramus. Deep to inferior ramus, there is thin kind of layer of muscles. There is pelvic floor. Pelvic floor is deep inside of pelvis, and it attaches to kind of the medial part of pubis because it's inside. So outside of pubic ramus, there is adductor muscles. If you go inside, if you go deep, you can approach to pelvic floor. So pubis is very important for a skeletal muscle and pelvic floor. Now let me talk about ischial tuberosity. What kind of muscles are around ischial tuberosity? The most famous one is hamstrings. Hamstrings, there are three muscles in hamstrings, right? Semitendinosus, semimembranosus, biceps femoris. All three muscles attach to ischial tuberosity. Plus, adductor magnus attaches to ischial tuberosity. Adductor magnus. It mainly attaches to inferior ramus, but adductor magnus is just big muscle, so it partially attaches to ischial tuberosity. Ah, that makes sense. And deep lateral rotators originate from around ischial tuberosity. It's like this, deep lateral rotator. Particularly gemellus muscles and quadratus femoris. You know, there are six muscles. So it's like three muscles of deep lateral rotator originate from ischial tuberosity. Well, it's close to ischial tuberosity. Hamstrings is there. Adductor magnus is there, and part of deep lateral rotator are around ischial tuberosity. See, there are so many muscles around bony landmark of pelvis. Iliac crest. On below the iliac crest, hip muscles are there. Above iliac crest, core muscles around a superior part. Pubis. Adductor muscles on inferior ramus. Above pubis, there is rectus abdominis. Now, ischial tuberosity. Hamstrings. Part of adductor magnus and part of deep lateral rotators. If you know this anatomy, you get access to bony structure or around bony structure. You may have much more efficient treatment in short amount of time because there are literally many muscles around bony structure. If you focus one place, you can access for numerous muscles, numerous myofascia. Thus, I tend to do myofascial release around bony structure. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.